Hello, Liz.
Hi.
Morning, Liz.
Hi, Liz.
Hi. I like that. You'd fell over almost, and then you were all of a sudden.
One too many sherries this morning.
Are you in Bardney?
No, I'm in Yorkshire.
You're in Yorkshire?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tom's jealous.
That's the advantage of technology, isn't it? You can join from wherever you are.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Where are we?
I'm in my mum's house and all I've got is a garden chair, so I'm sat on a garden chair.
That's the bells dinging for 10 o'clock, folks. Morning, Ernest.
Morning.
Ernest appeared in the background for a moment.
Yeah, and just appeared that quick as well.
Give him away. Let's begin. I'll just find the right thing to do. That and that. And now I'm going to share my screen and we will begin. There we go. Excellent. So we've arrived at the third Sunday of Advent. Didn't seem like it was going to, it was a long way away when we first started. Now it seems all very quick and very sudden. Time goes fast when you're having fun, they say. Mm. And today we're thinking about the third of the words for Advent, which is joy. And we're going to think a bit about that later on in our service. And Corinna's going to share with us and help us to reflect on God's word later on. I wonder how you've come this morning. I wonder what's in your heart. One of the things they're doing at school now, which I really like, is that when the kids arrive first thing in the morning, they have to say, how are you? And I'm either happy or sad or tired or good. And they have an emoji board. You can stick little emojis on saying how you feel. And sometimes it's easy to come and rush into church without remembering about that we come with all that's happened in this past week. And God asks us, if you like, how are you doing? How do you feel? What's going on? So just for a few moments, just to think of how am I? And then hold that in your heart as we come to worship. And then we pray together. Some of us are weary or downhearted. And still we say, let our hearts be glad. God is always here. We can approach God with confidence. Because God
has always been with us.
Let our hearts
be glad.
Amen. So we're going to sing our first hymn. Paul very carefully, kindly recorded this for me the other day, or I recorded him playing it. And when I got home and went to put it back into a video, I realised I hadn't turned the video on. I'd just taken a picture of Paul playing the organ. So this isn't Paul playing Heart of Glad Sound. It's a choir from Bristol, I believe.
All his grace, to our Lord.
So as we prepare to light our Advent candle, I'm going to say the bits in yellow, and if you could join in with the bits in white. As we light our Advent candle,
light of the world, shine on us.
As we prepare for Christmas time, light of
light of the world, shine on us.
In this world of pain and darkness, light of the world,
shine through us.
For all the people who do not know you,
light of the world, shine through us.
Jesus, you are coming again.
Light of the world, light the way.
In our service here today,
light of the world, light the way.
So we light our third Advent candle. In the light of God's love and his presence with us, we come to ask his forgiveness for those things which are not best, not right in our lives. And so we pray together. God,
you hovered over chaos
like a brooding,
hen, bringing order over chaos.
But we who thought
deed, misdeed, and omission
have quenched
the spirit of life that you give us.
We have
turned our faces away.
Now
we turn our faces back to you.
Light
of all light,
God
of all God,
and
ask for the light of your life
to lift
us again.
Bring us
out of chaos into the order of creation for your name's sake, and for the sake of your goodness among us.
God promises that he will pour out his spirit upon us to recreate, to renew, to refill, to refresh. So we ask, Heavenly Father, that you would pour afresh upon us your Holy Spirit, that we might know your forgiveness, your grace and mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Mm-hmm. So the notices, this Sunday, or it's already happened, but there will still be the chance. The chapel have held there, would normally be their toys and service today, which money goes to the local women's refuge. That's obviously not been able to happen in the same way because they're not able to receive gifts. But the chapel will be open, has been open already this morning, and can still receive gifts for the support of the women's refuge. And if you make checks towards payable towards the chapel, but all the money goes to Edan. Or if you want to, there is the Facebook button, which has appeared, hopefully have appeared again, and you can press that. And again, you can specify that that would go to support the work of Edan or the life of the church. Then this week, during the week, we've got morning prayer on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, compline on Tuesday and Thursday. If you want to take part in that, have a word with Corinna if you don't already get the emails with the links. And this Wednesday is a filling station Christmas special, and that'll be on the filling station page, Bardney Filling Station. And the link for that will be on the church's Facebook page as well. And then next weekend, obviously the messy nativity trail as it normally takes place can't happen, but there is going to be a socially distant trail whereby you walk around and engage with various things which are set up on different churches, but you will need to book a place on that. And if you need to do that, if you haven't booked a place already, then if you go to the Bardney Messy Church Facebook page, and again there's a link from the United Parish Facebook page, you can book a link. When I looked last time, there was only one space available, but the plan will be that if that fills up, then we'll introduce some extra time slots around it. But that will be next Saturday and next Sunday, sort of around about 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock, but the extra time will probably be half an hour before and half an hour after. And then next Sunday at 10 o'clock, we've got a carol service. At the moment, some of us will be in church, but it will also be streamed live on Zoom and Facebook. So you can join with us in that. And that'll be a simple service of carols and readings. So we'll look out for details of that. If it changes and we're not in church, we will let you know as soon as possible. So you need to have Corinna's mailing if you don't get that already, and watch the Facebook page. Next Sunday evening, Sudbury's got a carol service, but that is fully booked because they're doing socially distanced, so only a certain number of people can get in the church. And Stainfield now doing its carol service live on Facebook on the Stainfield and Apley Village Hall page and the United Parish page. So if you want to watch that, then that will be there next Sunday in the evening. And then Christmas week itself, on Wednesday next week, there will be a communion for Christmas. And I'm going to do that streamed from church on Wednesday morning at 10 o'clock. But that will then remain on the Facebook page so that at some point during the Christmas period, if you'd like to take part in communion, you can do that. Just that service will be there for you to look at. But also there will be various services which are being done by the church nationally, by the archbishops, and also by our local churches, by the bishops. So you can join in, including a midnight communion. Again, Chris Dingle on Christmas Eve will happen in some way or form. At the moment, the plan is to have a small group in church, but also that people can collect Chris Dingles in the run-up to that and take them home and join in the service at home and make your own Chris Dingle in your home and join in that way, and other people will be able to do that. But to have to happen, people will need to book their Chris Dingle packs to collect beforehand. And details of that will be next weekend. Gortby have got a carol service at 7 p.m. on Christmas Eve, which is fully booked. And Minting are pondering whether they're going to actually have a live service, whether they're going to stream a service for their carol service again at 7 p.m. And then on Christmas Day, there will be a simple service for Christmas morning at 9 o'clock. Watch this space. We'll see how it goes. Now we're going to have today's reading, and our first one is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And Roger's going to read this for us.
First reading is from 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 16 to 24. Rejoice always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not treat prophecies with contempt, but test them all. Hold on to what is good. Reject every kind of evil. May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm today is Psalm 126, and I thought we could try saying this together. Whether it works or not, so feel free to join in. When the Lord restored
the fortunes of Zion,
we were like
those who dreamed.
Our mouths
were filled with laughter,
our tongue
with songs of joy.
Then it was said
among the nations,
The Lord
has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us.
And we are filled with joy.
Restore our fortunes,
Lord.
Like the streams
in the Negev.
Those who sow with tears.
Will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping,
carrying seed to sow,
will return with songs of joy,
carrying sheaves with them.
Now Brenda's going to read for us from John's Gospel.
Gospel of John, chapter 1. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. Now this was John's testimony when the Jewish leaders in Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to ask him who he was. He did not fail to confess, but confessed freely. I am not the Messiah. They asked him, then who are you? Are you Elijah? He said, I am not. Are you the prophet? He answered, no. Finally, they said, who are you? Give us an answer to take back to those who sent us. What do you say for yourself? John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness. Make straight the way for the Lord. Now the Pharisees who had been sent questioned him, why then do you baptize if you are not the Messiah, nor Elijah, nor the prophet? I baptize with water, John replied, but among you stands one you do not know. He is the one who comes after me, the straps of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie. This all happened at Bethany, on the other side of the Jordan, where John was baptizing. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
God.
So we're going to sing our next hymn, Meekness and Majesty.
Meekness and Majesty.
That's not right. A minute, we'll start that again and see if we can get it going properly.
Meekness and majesty, manhood and deity, in perfect harmony, the man who is God, Lord of eternity, dwells in humanity, is in humility, and washes our feet. Oh, what a mystery! Meekness and majesty, God of my worship, for this is your God, this is your God. Father's glory radiance, affecting witnesses, let them so obedience to death on a cross, suffering to give us life, offering to sacrifice, grant us thankless divine grace, Father, forgive. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty.
Our mouths were filled with laughter, our tongues filled with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them, and the Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. So it's wonderful words from Psalm 126. Today is the third Sunday of Advent, and we have lit our third candle, the candle of joy. And I know that some of us are finding the prospect of joy difficult in our current situation. But if we are to believe what the scripture says, that is exactly how we should feel. But let us not get confused between happiness and joy, because they're not the same. It is thought that happiness is to be temporary and external, whereas joy is thought to be eternal and internal. And when we hear the readings for today, we find that they are full of joy. We heard in our reading from Isaiah of the joy that the Lord had sent, that had sent him to take the good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to comfort those who mourn. And many of us over the past months, while we've been in the midst of COVID-19, with all the restrictions and guidelines and the devastation that we've suffered, feel brokenhearted and oppressed and have had to mourn. So it's not as dissimilar to Isaiah that we too have been in our own form of exile. And our prayers have asked Jesus just what Isaiah promised that God would provide. In the same way with John the Baptist, he came out of the wilderness to baptize people in the River Jordan, not because he thought he was anyone special, but because he had been called by God to prepare the way for the Messiah. Our gospel reading this morning from John's gospel shows how unlike Jesus, who was thought to have said many times the words, "I am," John the Baptist constantly told the Pharisees he was not. He was not the Messiah. He was not the prophet Elijah. He was just a humble servant, preparing the way for someone who he felt unworthy even to untie his sandals for him. And the Pharisees asked him who was coming and when. John replied that he was already among them. When the Pharisees heard this, they were intrigued to know what this Messiah would look like. The prophet from the Old Testament had told of his comings and that he was going to be a great leader. So when John told them that the Messiah was among them, I imagine that they would have looked amongst the crowd, searching for someone who looked like they could lead an army or could win a political debate. We as Christians today are commissioned in the same way as John the Baptist, and we have a lot in common with both John and the crowd in today's society. We are told that we too are to prepare the way for Jesus as he is coming again, while at the same time rejoicing in the knowledge that he has been here before, that he was in the Old Testament spiritually, and then again in the New Testament in the flesh. And many of us have spent time in the wilderness discerning what it is that God is calling us to do and how. And throughout the Old Testament and the New Testament, we hear of people going into the wilderness to find God and to seek what it is we're meant to do. And some of us just might ask the same question as the Pharisees. What does the Messiah look like? Do we have an advantage over those who were standing by the River Jordan? We can certainly rejoice in the knowledge that we know that Jesus isn't some political leader wanted to be voted in as our next prime minister or to be the next general in an army. We know from our scripture that he is a man of love, of mercy and of compassion. We know that he died for our sins. We know that he is our healer, protector, and our guide to the kingdom of heaven. But would we know him if he walked amongst us? I imagine it'd be like going to the airport to meet someone at arrivals and only knowing their name and not what they looked like. Standing there on the barriers with a big poster saying, "Messiah, this way, your car is waiting." And wondering, is that the one, as each person comes through the gates? Wondering who the Messiah was and what he looked like. This week we celebrate joy and what it means to us. For John the Baptist and the crowd, it meant that the Messiah had arrived. And that if the prophets were to believe, this Messiah was going to change the world for the better. As Christians, we have the same sense of joy at this time of year, as we start preparing to celebrate the birth of Jesus, whilst also remembering that he died for our sins. Through these past months, where we have been affected by COVID-19, there has been no better time to remember what Jesus has done for us. As we think about the Christmas story, we are encouraged to know that Jesus is who he says he is, and that he will do what he says he will do. The challenge for us is to keep rejoicing, to keep praying, and to keep holding fast, and to carry on. So I say to you, let us walk in John the Baptist's footsteps. As we learn to follow in Jesus' footsteps to fulfill the prophecies of the Old Testament prophets. And so let us pray. Lord, fill your people with the joy of possessing graces like those of John the Baptist, and direct the minds of all in the way of salvation and peace. John was martyred for truth and justice. So may we, dear God, energetically profess our faith in you and help us to lead others to your way, your truth, and your eternal life. Amen.
To sing our next hymn, and can it be that I should gain?
And in Gospel passage, we read that when people were praying for the Messiah to come, that the Messiah was already there amongst them. You never need to look for God, as if God is not already here. Instead, we need to turn to God, who's always here, always ready, always listening. Let's take a few moments to listen to the breath, the heart that is always beating, knowing that as surely as the heart beats, God is always with us. And perhaps the challenge for us in the coming days is to make those few moments of space to listen to the breath, the heartbeat of God, knowing that He's always there with us. We might recognize the Messiah wherever we are and whatever we're doing. Those prayers of intercession, be just a few moments of silence, and I'm going to pray the bits in yellow and you can join in the bits in blue. The Messiah came to rescue those who were on the edges, on the margins. And so we pray today for all who are downtrodden, all who are oppressed, all who know the heavy hand of marginalization on them. God, we turn to you, remembering the words of Mary, praying that you will lift up the lame, you will raise the voice of justice, and you will scatter oppression. May all who are oppressed be set free. We ask this
joy and gratitude.
In your name.
In your name we pray. Amen.
We pray that we might find rhythms of life that sustain us here. Rhythms for cultivating and renewing human community, justice, and creativity.
We ask this.
In joy
and gratitude.
In your name.
In your name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
And then a few moments where we just bring the cries of our own hearts to our Father in heaven. People we're concerned about, perhaps circumstances that are on our hearts and minds, peoples and places, praying that the Messiah is there with you to hear your prayer.
So we gather our prayers together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be
done
on earth
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day
our daily bread,
and forgive
us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver
us from evil.
For
thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory,
forever
and ever.
It's very easy to see the collection as just something we do in the service, but actually the giving of our resources is actually an act of worship. And it's easy to forget. We tend to see it about just being about giving the money to keep the church going, but actually it's an offering to God of service to him, of worship to him. And so if you would like to use the giving button on Facebook, that would be lovely. Or if you'd like to get on a regular basis, have a chat with Harry about the parish giving scheme. But it may be that you already do those things and you want to just in your mind picture your gift and offering them to God as part of your worship and saying, God, I'm giving this to you because it's my heart's gift, my sacrifice to you. Remember how God gave to us as we sing our final hymn, I will sing the wondrous story. So a prayer as we
finish our time together. We pray together. Gathered in, Lord, we have been nurtured by your Spirit of life. Now sent out, we go in the assurance that your word lasts forever and your promises are true. Let the lowly be lifted up. Let the hungry be fed. Let the mighty listen.
God
who is merciful, hears
all.
Come,
and let us go
in the blessed joy
of God's kindness. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And we pray for one another in the words of the blessing. May the peace
of the Lord
wherever
we may send us.
May he guide us
through the wilderness, protect us through the storm. May he bring us home rejoicing.
The one
as he has shown us. May he bring us home rejoicing.
Once again.
Into our doors.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you. And remain with you today and always.
Amen.